In Creo Parametric, you can replace the model used in a drawing view in three situations. Let's take a look at that. Right now in my drawing, I'm on sheet number one. Let's go to sheet number two. And here we have the engine block. You can select it and then right click and choose open if you want to open it up in its own separate window. This is the original version of the model, but I have another model in which that particular part appears as an inheritance feature in the new part. And this new part represents the casting of the engine block. And so there are a number of features that are machined later on, so they are not included in the inheritance. We can replace the original model with this model that uses it as a reference in the drawing views. Let's go back to the drawing. To execute the command, you can do it from the Layout tab. We could choose Replace View Model. I'm going to select this top view over here. And when I select the top view, it automatically selects the parent view and any other views that are dependent on the parent view. Here we have an option to delete the original view model from the drawing. And if I didn't have that model, original model, appear in any other drawing views, I could do this in order to reduce the weight of this drawing. But this particular model is used in sheet one, so there's no point doing that. You can also replace callouts and repeat regions, and this allows you to customize the scale of the view. There are three different ways. Right now, family table is grayed out because this part doesn't have a family table. You could use a simplified representation, but we're going to use reference model. Then I will click the open button. Let's grab the casting version of the part and then click open. And then I will click OK. And now if you take a look in the model tree, it is using the engine block casting. And a number of the dimensions are still on the sheet because they have the same dimensions in the reference model. Now let's go to another part. Here is the crankshaft. This time to replace, we can select a view when we're on the layout tab and then hold down the right mouse button. And from the menu, you can choose Replace View Model. This time, family table is available because this particular part is an instance of a family table. Let's choose the open button to select which instance that we want. And I could say, hey, let's choose this one over here and click the OK button and then OK. And the part got a little bit longer in here. There you can see in the model tree that's listing the instance and as well as the generic. And once again, we can select a view, right mouse click and hold, and replace view model. Do it one more time by family table, hit the open button. This time I'm going to grab this particular instance and click OK and OK. And again, we have an even longer version of the part now in the drawing. Let's go to the fourth sheet on here. Here we have a part and it's got a lot of complex geometry in here, a lot of cuts in here. And this time we will replace by a simplified representation. I will right click on it and then choose Replace View Model. And again, it selects the parent view and any other dependent views. This time we'll do it by simplified representation. I'll click the open button. It'll list any other part simplified reps. Here I have one for no cuts. I'll click OK and then OK. And in this particular situation, because a number of features that were detailed went away, some of the different dimensions were taken off of the drawing sheet. So again, those are the three different ways that you could use Replace View Model. You can do it by family table if it is a generic or an instance, simplified rep, or reference model. I hope you enjoyed this video. For more information, please visit www.creowindchill.com. If you learned something from this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you like this video, please click the subscribe button and ring the bell to be informed when new videos are uploaded. Thank you very much.